Well, here's a review of them, probably 2 years late. Here you have the LePi LP2020A Plus. This is the newest revision of their amp, and I'm going to do a full put together of a very simple 2.0, like my 2.0 post says. We got the Behringer UCA202 DAC. Again, this is optional if you think your sound card's good enough, but frankly, just having real RCAs to plug into makes life just more proper and not obsessive. Leave me alone. So, the amp costs under $25. This is the first time I bought one of these. I bought the Topping. I bought the Indeed also. They're a little bit higher end. So we're going to hook this all up. I've got the DAC hooked up. Foobar is playing to it. I made these cables. You know, the ones I link are just as good. Output left and right. And then we go into the amplifier. If you screw up the colors, it's not my fault. Red and white are not that hard. Okay, this will also accept a 3.5 millimeter. So if you have an auxiliary cable, that'll work. The wire I'm using here is the wire I link, which is the 14 gauge shielded. And I just took my wire strippers, peeled off the shielding, stripped it about that much. A little bit more than a quarter inch is all you really need. And I'm going to that's one. That's two. Make sure you don't curl up any of the strands. You don't want them to touch. That'll be bad. Yes, just fits in there. Right, and all that's left on this is power. Now, here is the power adapter that comes with the LePi 2020 Plus, the one that's on Amazon saying, oh, new power supply, blah, blah, blah. It's still a 2 amp. It's still this little thing, so throw that away. Here is the 6 amp power brick that costs like $8 or $9. It's super cheap. I recommend you use it instead. Now, don't turn on the amplifier yet because we have exposed wires. You could probably leave the plugging into later. And because they're still good enough speakers for home use, here are the Dayton B652s. My Mica X's are at home, and all my other Micas are ripped apart. They'll be reassembled with the crossover kits available on Micatron. And I'll show you how those get installed. Speaker one. Again, everything's color-coded. Give these a little pull up. Make sure everything's attached. There's speaker two, and I'm being obsessive and wanting to put them apart, even though it shouldn't matter for this video. All right, make sure the volume is down. Anything with an analog volume knob, you don't want to leave it all the way up and then flip the switch and, oh my God, everything blew up. So all the way down. This amp has tone and direct. Direct, which is out, basically means these bass and treble controls do nothing. I would probably recommend that. See that pretty blue light? It's very blue. It gives a click after you turn it on. These are down to zero. Turn it up. Jesus, that's a powerful amplifier. Okay, I'm going to turn on the tone. I'm going to leave these at zero, turn it up. Oh, we're going to distort the hell out of the bass. Alright, so when this button is out, direct stands for 5 and 5. Because there's no change in sound when I have it in or out now. So leave those vertical or leave it on direct. They'll sound fine. If you have really crappy speakers hooking up something old, play with it as you see fit. Usually you just want to leave it flat. I got this for a reason. Let's see if we could hit 90 dB in the listening position, which I'm assuming is That's 92 dB from 4 feet away, 3 feet away. And the volume knob on the Li-Pi is at around 11 o'clock. And I'm probably never going to get this video on because for some reason I left Metallica playing. God, wow, that's really loud. This isn't joking. This might get louder than the damn Indeed amp. Right, I'm going to enable the tone control. I'm going to lower the bass. I'll lower them both down to zero. I'll try this from there. Half volume. Yeah, these are just a ridiculously powerful little amplifier. I think that 6 amp transformer has a lot to do with it. I'm tempted to pull out the Andrew Jones Pioneers and give those a whirl. Because this amp claims down to 2 ohms drive, and 2 ohms are very, very hard to drive speakers. I like it.